Dear children, it is a solution of the multiple choice questions based model question paper 1 given by the office of the Deputy Director of Public Instruction, Chamarajanagara District. Four choices are given for each of the questions. Incomplete statements. Choose the correct answer and shade the correct choice in the OMR given to you with blue or black ballpoint pen. Take the first question. A1x plus B1y plus C1 equals 0 and A2x plus B2y plus C2 equals 0. Pair of linear equations which forms intersecting lines, then the ratio of their coefficient is. Here they are the intersecting lines. Intersecting lines means, you know, this question is repeated question. So which is the answer for the intersecting lines? A1 by A2 is not equals to B1 by B2. Option A is the answer. It is a direct question. Next, to take the second question, by solving a pair of linear equations 2x plus y equals 7 and x minus y equals minus 1, the value of x and y are. Value of x and y are. Here we have to solve this equation. You consider the second equation below this equation only, minus 1. And here these two are having different sign with the same coefficient. You can cancel by first plus second. So first plus second means 2x plus x equals 3x. And 7 plus minus 1 is 6. Then you will get x equals 6 by 3, which is equals to 2. Then you take the value of y here. That becomes x minus y equals minus 1 is there. So in the place of x you take, in the place of x, 2 minus y equals minus 1, then minus y equals minus 1 minus 2, this becomes minus 3, so y equals what? 3. Here minus y equals minus 3, then y equals 3, so option D is the answer. What is the answer? Option D, x equals 2, y equals 3. Option D is the answer, note down. Next you take the third question. Third question, roots of the ordinary equation x square minus 4x plus 4 equals 0 are. Here use the factorization method to get the roots. The factors becomes, here the product is 4x square and the sum of the roots is minus 4x. Then in which table 4 is there, you know, in 4 ones are and in 2 twos are. So you take 4x square here and the product is having positive sign, therefore the factors are having same sign. That is the same sign of the middle term, sign of the middle term. So minus minus. So that is minus 2x minus 2x. Then if you write this equation, it becomes x square minus 2x minus 2x plus 4 equals 0. Then you take the common x into x minus 2. Here minus 2 is common, x minus 2 equals 0. Then you will get x minus 2 into x minus 2 equals 0. So the roots are 2 and 2. Equate each factor to 0, you will get 2. So the answer is here. What is the answer? Here x equals 2. You got x equals 2. So you got x equals 2, x equals 2. So option C is the answer. You got 2, 2. And also here you can use the relation, this is in the form of a minus b the whole square, that is x square minus 2 into 2x plus 2 square, that is it becomes x minus 2 the whole square equals 0, then x minus 2 equals 0, that is 2 root, x equals 2 you will get, so as it is a square you will get 2 2, therefore option C is the answer. Then you take the fourth one. 2x minus 3y equals minus 1 and x equals 4. Then the value of y. Then the value of y. Here you take the value of x. That becomes 2 into 4 minus 3y equals minus 1. That becomes 8 minus 3y equals minus 1. Then minus 3y equals minus 1 minus 8. If you transfer this to the RHS, then you will get minus 3y is equals to minus 9, which is y is equals to minus 9 by minus 3, which is equals to 3. So then what is the answer? option B is the answer. You got the answer option B. Note down the answer option B. Here x value is given. So in the equation 2x minus y equals minus 1, substitute the value of x, that becomes 2 4 is 8. Then you solve for y. Then you take the fifth question. The nth term of AP is given by an equals 4 minus 3n. Then the common differences. To find the common difference, A2 and A1 are required. A2 minus A1. Any two consecutive terms are required. So let us find A1 and A2. Here A1 equals 4 minus 3 into 1, which is equals to 4 minus 3 equals 1. A2 equals 4 minus 3 into 2, which is equals to 4 minus 6, that is minus 2. Then D equals A2 minus A1, which is equals to minus 2 minus 1, that is minus 3. Then what is the answer? Option B is the answer. Note down, you got minus 3. Option B is the answer. Then you take the next question, question number 6. There are 4 terms in AP in which sum of the first and last term is 13 and the product of the middle term is 40. Then the terms of the given AP is. Here you observe the condition given. What is given? Sum of first and last term is 13. Sum of first and last term is 13. So find the option here in which the first condition is satisfied. Here the sum of first and last is 12, so it is not an option. And sum of first and second is 16, it is not an answer. Here you can take sum of this first and last is 13. Here also sum of these two is 13. Second condition, product of middle terms is 40. Here you can say this as the answer. Here 5 8 is 40, product of middle term. Here 6 8 is 48. This is not an answer. So which is the answer here? Option B. Option B is the answer. Here the sum of first and last is 13 and the product of the middle term is 40. So the condition is satisfied by the option B. So option B is the answer. Option B is the answer. Next, you take the seventh question. The sum of first n terms of AP is given by Sn equals 2n square plus n. Then the AP is. Here what is given? Sn is given. And what you have to find out? We have to find the AP. To find the AP, first term is required and D is required. And first term you can get easily, that is nothing but S1. And to get D, A2 is required. So find A2. To get A2, you must find out S2 also. S2 minus S1 is A2. So you write first S1. S1 is nothing but A or A1. S1 equals what? 2 into 1 square plus 1. That is equals to 2 into 1 square is 2 into 1 plus 1, which is equals to 2 1s are 2 plus 1, 3. So you got A3. Then also get A2. A2 is equals to what? To get A2, you need S2. So take S2. S2 equals 2 into 2 square plus 2. 2 into 2 square. 2 into 2 square, that you know, 2 into 4. 2 square is 4 plus 2. 2 4s are 8. 8 plus 2, 10. You got S2 and S1. Then here A2 equals what? S2 minus S1. You know that relation. What is that relation? An equals Sn minus Sn minus 1. The same relation used here. So S2 minus S1. S2 is 10. S1 is 3. So you got A2, 7. Then D equals A2 minus A1, 7 minus 3. 7 minus 3 is what? 4. So you got the first term 3, and 3 plus 4, 7. Where is there? 3 is only here and here. So here 3 plus 7, 3 plus D is 4, 3 plus 4 becomes 7, it is not AP. So 3 plus 4, 7, 7 plus 4, 11, 11 plus 4, 15. So option D is the answer. Here you got A is 3 and D is 4. So to get the next term, 4 must be added to the previous term. So the condition is satisfied by the D here. So option D is the answer. Option D is the answer. Then take the next question. What is the question? Question number 8. The sum of first 10 natural number is, you know that formula, 10 into 10 plus 1 by 2. N into N plus 1 by 2, that is 10 into 10 plus 1 by 2. 10 into 10 plus 1 by 2, 2 1s are 2 5s are 5 into 11, which is equals to 55. So which is the answer here? Option A is the answer. It is a repeated question, many times solved. Now the ninth question. In an AP, first term and common difference are 5 and 3, then its 20th term is. First term and common difference are 5 and 3. First term is A, common difference is 3, 20th term. That is A20 equals A plus 19D. A is the first term, that is 5, plus 19 into 3, 5 plus 19, 3 is 57. Then you will get 57 plus 5 is 62. Then what is the answer? Option A is the answer. Then what is the answer? Option A is the answer. Note on the answer, option A. Then you take the question number 10. What is that question number 10? The discriminant of the quadratic equation 2x square minus 5x plus 3 equals 0. Here you know the discriminant is b square minus 4ac. B is the coefficient of x, that is minus 5 whole square minus 4 into a is 2, c is 3. That is minus 5 whole square is 25. 4 2s are 8, 8 3s are 24. You will get 1. Then what is the answer? Option C is the answer. Note down the answer, option C. Next, you take the question number 11. The roots of the quadratic equation. The roots of the quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c equals 0. Roots of the quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c equals 0. Here there is a formula, you know the formula, minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. Here minus b is there, plus c is there, it is not the answer. Here a is not there, here a is there, but minus b is not there. Here minus b is there, plus or minus is there, square root of b square minus 4ac is there, by 2a is there. So what is the answer? Option D is the answer. Note down the answer. Option D. Next, you take the question number 12. The length of a rectangle is twice of its breadth. If its area 50 square units, then its length and breadth are. Here, what is given? Length of a rectangle is twice of its breadth. If you take breadth is B, then L becomes 2B, and L into B is 50, that is 2B into B equals 50 B square. B square equals 50 by 2, 2 was a 2, 25 is a, so you got B is equals to whole root 25, so you take 5. Here you got B equals 5, then L equals 2 into 5, which is equals to 10, so 10 and 5. 10 units and 5 units are the length and breadth. So then what is the answer? Answer is option C. 10 units and 12 units. Then you take the next question. Question number 13. Which of the following is a quadratic equation? Which of the following is a quality equation. Here now you take the first one, x plus 1 whole square. You can use the identity a plus b the whole square, that is square of the first term x square 2 into ab 2 into x plus 1 equals 3x is there. You can transfer this to the LHS, it becomes 0. Then x square 2x minus 3x is minus x plus 1 equals 0. So here what is the answer? Option A. Directly you can have, this is a quadratic equation. Note down the answer. Option A is the answer. Then you take the question number 14. Which of the following standard trigonometric angles are not defined? Which of the following standard trigonometric angles are not defined? Here cot 90 is there, sin 90 is there, cos 90 is there, tan 90 is there. You know that sin 90 is 1, cos 90 is 0, and sin by cos, tan is sin by cos, that is 1 by 0, and cot is cos by sin, that is 0 by 1. And 0 by 1 you get 0, and these are the values, and here this one you can't define, it is not defined. What is that? Option D, tan 90 cannot be defined. You must know the chart. If you know the chart, directly you can identify the answer, or otherwise you can identify by your logic thinking and concept learning. So which is the answer here? Option D is the answer. Then you take the question number 15. Sin theta equals 12 by 13. Then the value of tan theta is. Sin theta is 12 by 13. Then the value of tan theta. Now if you take the theta, you know sin theta is equals to opposite side by hypotenuse. Opposite side by hypotenuse. So opposite side is here 12. Hypotenuse is 13, and if you use the Pythagorean triplet, directly you can get the measurement of the other side, because to find the tan theta, adjacent side is required. Tan theta is equals to opposite side by adjacent side, and if you use the Pythagorean triplet, you know that 12, 13 and other must be 5, 12, 13. Here you know that 13 square, square root of 13 square minus 12 square, you will get 169 minus 144, which is equals to 25, 5. If you know it directly, you can get the other side also, because it is a right angle triangle. In right angle triangle, the measurements of the three sides is considered to be the Pythagorean triplets. If you know the set of Pythagorean triplets, directly you can identify the third side. So here, or otherwise by using the Pythagoras theorem. Here you know that square on the hypotenuse is equal to sum of the squares on the other two sides. That also you can use here. But here you must have the fundamental knowledge to get the answer. So here it is 5. Got, it is a 5. Adjacent side is 5. So for tan theta, opposite side by adjacent side, that is 12 by 5. What is the answer? Answer is 12 by 5. Note down the answer, 12 by 5. Then you take the next one, 16th one. Sin alpha minus beta equals 1 by 2. Cos alpha plus beta is equals to 1 by 2. Where alpha plus beta less than 90, then the value of alpha and beta. Here sin alpha plus beta is equals to half. In sin, how much degree is half? You know that sin 30 is 1 by 2. Sin 30 is 1 by 2. That is alpha minus beta is equals to 30 degree. And cos alpha plus beta is equals to 1 by 2. That is cos 60 degrees 1 by 2. So you will get alpha plus beta. Alpha plus beta is equals to what? 60 degree. Then here you know that if you add this first and second, this coefficient are same for the beta. So you can cancel by adding them. then you will get 2 alpha is equals to 60 plus 30, how much? 90. So you got alpha is equals to 90 by 2, which is equals to 45. Then you know that to get the other measurement, alpha plus beta is equals to 60 degree, you got alpha is equals to 45, means beta is equals to 60 minus 45 degree, which is equals to 15 degree. Here what is the answer? Options are 45 degree and 50 degree. So option B is the answer. Option B is the answer. Note down the answer, option B. Here you must know the values of the trigonometric ratios. Sin 30 is 1 by 2, cos 60 is 1 by 2. If you don't know that one, you can't identify the answer. Then you take 17th question, the value of sin square 48 degree plus sin square 42 degree. Value of sin square 48 degree plus sin square 42 degree. Here you know that you convert sin into cos or cos into 9, because these two are the complementary angles. So you write that is equals to sin square 48 degree plus sin square 90 minus 48 is nothing but 42. So you write 90 minus 48 degree, that becomes sin square 48 degree. Sin 90 minus theta is cos theta, so it is cos 48 degree. Cos 48 degree, you know that sin square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1. So sin square 48 degree plus cos square 48 degree is 1. So what is the answer here? Option A is the answer. Option A is the answer. Note down the answer. Here you must know the complementary angles and also the identity sin square theta plus cos square theta equals 1. You must know this one. Next you take the question number 18. A man observes a car from a top of building of height 50 meter. If the angle of depression is 45 degree, then the distance between the car and foot of the building is. What is that question? A man observes a car from the top of a building of height 50 meter. If the angle of depression is 45 degree, then the distance between the car and foot of the building is. Here what is given? Man observes a car from the top of a building. Here there is a building. Here is a man who observes the car from the top. Consider here is a car. Then angle of depression is 45 degree. Here depression means, consider here, this is the line of sight, horizontal. This becomes the 45 degree. So this is 45, means you must consider this is 45 degree. Then what is given here? Top of the building of height 50 meter. And here this is 45, means this is also 45 degree, because it is an isosceles triangle. These two sides are equal. Therefore it is 50 meter. That is also 52 meter. The distance between the car and the foot of the building is 50 meter, as you got isosceles right angle triangle. Option D is the answer. Next you take the question number 19. The coordinates of the point P of xy, which divides the line segment joining the points A of x1 y1 and B of x2 y2 in the ratio m1 is to m2 is. Here you must know the formula. If you know the formula directly, you can identify the answer. Otherwise you can't identify the answer. So you must know that formula. What is that? M1 x2 plus m2 x1 by m1 plus m2, m1 y2 plus m2 y1 by m1 y2. Here in the first m1 x2, but here minus is there. So it is this is not answer. Here m1 x1, m2 x2 is there. So this is not the answer. So you can identify this is the answer. Note down the answer, option C. If you know the formula, easily you can identify the answer. It is a direct question. Next you take the question number 20. distance of the point 68 from the origin. Distance of the point 68 from the origin. So here, to find the distance of the point from the origin, here again you must know the Pythagorean triplets and also about the Pythagoras theorem, because here you will get a right angle triangle. So 6 and 8 are there, then the Pythagorean triplets, you know, 6, 8, 10. So 10 units becomes the answer. So here you observe, point is here 6, 8. Here you have to find the distance from the origin. So this is 6, this is 8. First one is the x coordinate, this is the y coordinates. Then here you use the Pythagoras theorem, that becomes 8 square plus 6 square. So you will get 64 plus 36, and if that is 100, its root. Root is 10. Here if you consider, this is OA. So OA square is equals to 8 square plus 6 square. Then OA equals root 100, which is equals to 10 unit. Here the question asked is distance from the origin, not from the x axis or not from the y axis. So if the distance is asked from the origin, you must use the Pythagorean triplets or Pythagoras theorem. Then you take the, here what is the answer? Answer is option A, 10 units. Then you take the question number 21. If midpoints of the line joining coordinates A 2 minus 5 and BXY is origin, coordinates of BXY is. Here what is given? Midpoints of the line joining the points A and B is given. Line joining the point A and B is given. And coordinates of A is given. Coordinates of B is given XY. Here what you have to find out? We have to find the value of X and Y. And also, it is given that the midpoints of the line joining these two points is origin. So you can have this plus this. You take here. You know that midpoint, this is x1, y1, x2, y2. x1 plus x2 by 2 is origin, 0. x1 plus x2 by 2 is 0. So here x1 is 2. 2 plus x by 2. 2 plus x equals 0 you will get. Then x equals minus 2. X equals minus 2. Similarly, y1 plus y2 by 2 is equals to 0. And y1 is minus 5. Minus 5 plus y equals 0. So y is equals to 5. So minus 2 and 5. Minus 2 and 5. What is the answer here? Option B is the answer. Minus 2 and 5, option B is the answer. Here coordinates of the midpoints is given, and it is said that is 0, 0. Midpoint is origin, that is 0, 0. You know that coordinates of the origin is 0, 0. So if you take the midpoints, and here x1 plus x2 by 2 is 0, y1 plus y2 by 2 is 0, then you solve for x and y. Solve for x and y, because x2 and xy are x and y here. Then you take the question number 22. Distance of the point A 4, 5 from the x axis. Distance of the point A 4 minus 5 from the x axis. Here we have to find the distance of the point from the x axis. Distance of the point from the x axis means you have to take the y value. That is, minus 5 is there, but distance is positive, means it must be 5 units. What is the answer here? Option C is the answer. 5 units. Distance is always positive. So you take, even though the coordinates is negative, you must take the distance 5 units. Next you take the question number 23. In the following distribution table, the class interval which containing median is. The class interval which containing median. So here you get the cumulative frequency, CF you get 2, and 2 plus 3 5, 5 plus 5 10, 10 plus 3 13, 13 plus 2 15, then 15 by 2 you will get 7.5. nearer means here CF you will get 10. Then it is the CF of the class interval 20-30. Class interval 20-30. So what is the answer? Option B is the answer. Note down the answer, option B. Then you take the question number 24. The mean of the following distribution table is. The mean of the following distribution table. Here it is a frequency distribution table. So you know the formula sigma fi xy by summation of xy. Sigma fi xy means you get 10 2s are 20, 23s are 60, 34s are 120 and 41s are 40. And the sum of this. 20 plus 60, 80, 80 plus 120, 200, 200 plus 40, 240. And some sigma fi, sum of all the frequencies, 2 plus 3, 5, 5 plus 9, 5 plus 4, 9, 9 plus 1, 10. 10, so you will get 24. So option D is the answer. Then you take the question number 25. The mean and median of the scores are 30 and 32 respectively, then its mode is, mean and median of the scores are 30 and 32, and its mode, you know the relation among mean median mode, that is the empirical relation among mean median mode, that is 3 median equals mode plus 2 mean, or 2 mean plus mode, 2 mean plus mode. Then here what you have to find out, you have to find mode. It equals 3 into median. Median is 32. 3 into 32 minus 2 into mean. Mean is 30. 2 into 30. So 32 3s are 96 minus 60. 96 minus 60 is 36. So here mode equals 36. Equals mode it is. Roughly you calculate and find what is the answer here. Option D is the answer. You must know the formula and also you know the tricks to calculate easily. Here you must transfer this directly and you will get that mode. Next you take the question number 26. In the given figure, angle ABC equals 90 degree, BD perpendicular to AC, AC equals 9 cm and AD is equals to 4 cm, then the length of AB is. Here it is given angle ABC. Angle ABC is how much? That is 90 degree. BD is perpendicular to AC. What is given here? AC is given. Complete AC. That is, this AC is 9 and AD. AD is 4. And what you have to find out? AB is to be find out. And in the previous video, we discussed about some relation in this type of figure. So you take here AB square equals. AB square equals this whole AC into AD. AC into AD. AC is 9. AD is 4. Then AB square equals 36. AB equals what? Root 36, which is equals to 6. Here we discussed that. This whole square, AB square is equals to this whole into this. Similarly, this BC square equals to this whole into this part. And also, this square, BD square is equals to this into this. You must know that relation. It is discussed in the previous videos. So, you got AB equals 6. What is the answer? Answer is option B, 6. Then you take the next question, question number 27. Which of the following set of numbers form a right angled triangle? Which of the following set of numbers form a right angled triangle? Again here it is discussed that you must know the Pythagorean triplet. If you know the Pythagorean triplet, then you can make out the answer easily. So here which is the Pythagorean triplets? If you know it directly, 7, 24, 25. Option C is the answer. Here how you can make out square of a bigger number, that is 15 square 225, 13 square 169, 5 square 25. If you add these two, 9 plus 5, 14, and 6 plus 3, 9, you will get 194. So it is not a Pythagorean triplet. Here also, 30 square 169 and 12 square 144, 100 square. Here the sum of this becomes 244, which is not a Pythagorean triplet. Here also 25, 36, 49. Sum of this must not is equal to this one. But here you know 25 square, 625. 24 square, 24 square is 576 and 7 square is 49. So we'll get 9 plus 6, 15 and 625 we'll get. Therefore, option C is the answer. You must know the Pythagorean triplet directly. Know some Pythagorean triplet. You can make out them easily. Next, you take 28. Triangle LMN is similar to triangle XYZ and the ratio of their perimeter is 9:4. The ratio of their areas is Here one thing you keep in your mind that the ratio of the perimeter is equals to the ratio of the corresponding sides. So sides are also in the ratio 9:4. Their areas must be in the ratio 9 square 81 is to 16. So what is the answer here? Option C is the answer. Perimeter and sides of the similar triangles. Perimeter and sides of the similar triangles are in same ratio. The ratios are equal. Therefore, here you got the ratio of the perimeter means that is the ratio of their corresponding sides. That is also 9:4. So you take the square, 9 square and 4 square. Then you will get what? 18:16. So the option C is the answer. Then you take the question number 29. In triangle ABC, DE is parallel to BC, AD equals 4 cm, AB equals 6 cm, AE equals 6 cm, then the length of EC. Here what is given? AD is 4 and AB is 6. Then AE is given. A is how much? 6 cm. Then here you find DB. DB is 6 minus 4, 2. And according to Thales theorem, you can use what is that? AD by DB equals AE by EC. Then AD is 4, DB is 2, AE is 6 by EC. Then EC equals, you can take 6 into 2 by 4, then 2 2's are, 2 3's are. So you will get EC equals how much? 3 cm. What is the answer? Option A. EC equals 3 cm. Here, to find EC, you can use the Thales theorem because here this part you know. That is 6 minus 4. Then you take the question number 30. In a triangle, square of one side is equals to the sum of the squares of the other two sides. Then the angle between other two sides is. Here what is given? In a triangle, square of one side is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides. Then the angles between other two sides is, you know that is always right angle. It is always right angle triangle, right angle. And you know that it is the converse of the Pythagoras theorem. In a triangle, if a square of one side is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides, then those two sides contain the right angle. So option B is the answer. Next, you take the question number 31. The number of tangents drawn to a circle from a point inside it. You know that it is not possible to draw the tangents from a point inside it. If you consider here a circle, is it possible to draw the tangents to the circle from the point inside the circle? It is very clear you can't draw tangent. So what is the answer here? Option A, 0. Then you take the question number 32. The distance between the centers of externally touching circles of radii 4 cm and 2 cm is. Here the externally touching circles, consider the two circles which touches externally. This is a point of contact. Here consider this is the radius 4 cm, this is the radius 2 cm. The distance between the centers O1, O2 you take, the sum of these two, 4 plus 2 you will get. 4 plus 2, the distance between the center of these circles which touches externally. Externally means the centers of the circles are on the other, both the sides of the point of contact. So the sum becomes the distance between their centers. So 4 plus 2 is 6. So option A is the answer. If the touches externally means, here this is the figure to be noted. Here one more circle if you draw here. If they intersect here, they are intersect. But when they touches, if they touches at only one point, here you can draw the circle. Here they touches at one point and the centers are on both the sides of this point of touching. So the distance between the center becomes the sum of this radii and this radii. Here the two radii are given, 4 cm and 2 cm, therefore that is 4 plus 2, 6. Then you take the question number 33. In the figure, O is the center of the circle, AB is a chord, OP perpendicular to AB, radius 5 cm, OP 3 cm, then the length of AB. Here what is given? AB is a chord, OP is perpendicular to AB, and the radius is given, that is 5 cm. And OP, this is OP, that is the distance between the center and the chord, that is the perpendicular distance. So here OP is given 3. Then what is asked here? AB is asked. So here you get this length, and you know that here you can use the Pythagoras theorem, you can use the Pythagorean triplets. Here 3 and 5 are there, means it is 4. And chord is bisected by this P, because OP perpendicular to AB, the perpendicular drawn from the center to the chord bisect the chord, that you have learned in 9th standard. So here OP bisects AB. So if you got this is 4, means this is also 4. 4 plus 4, 8. What is the length of AB? That is 8 cm. Here you must use the concept that you have learnt in 9th standard. Perpendicular drawn from the center to the chord, bisect the chord. So if you know this PB, and double of it becomes the length of the chord AB. And to get this 4, 4 you will get if you know the Pythagorean triplet, or otherwise use the Pythagoras theorem, considering this as a hypotenuse. Next question, question number 34. The sides of the given triangle 4 cm, 5 cm and 6 cm and the corresponding sides of the other triangle which is similar to the given triangle are 6 cm, 7.5 cm, 9 cm. Then the ratio of their corresponding sides. Here it is given 4, 6, 5, 7.5, 6, 9. So 4 by 6. 5 by 7.5 and 6 by 9. The ratio becomes 2 2s are 2 3s are. Here also 2.5 2s are 2.5 3s are. 3 2s are 3 3s are. So ratio you will get 2 by 3. But here it is not said that the ratio of the sides which you have to taken above and which you have to taken below. Only they asked the ratio of the corresponding sides. So you got 2 by 3. Here 2 by 3 is the ratio, means again the ratio may be 3 by 2 also. Therefore you can consider option D is the answer. 2/3 or 3/2. The ratio of the corresponding sides are, you can take 2/3 or 3/2. Here you got 2/3, but here 3/2 is there. So you can consider it is 3/2 also. Then you take, at certain time a tree of 8 meter high cast a shadow of length 6 meter. At the same time, the length of shadow of building 6 meter high is. Here, the height of the tree is how much? 8 meter. And what is the length of its shadow? Length of its shadow is 6 meter. And at the same time, length of the shadow of the building is to be find out here. What is the height of the building? Height of the building is 6 meter. So consider here is a building. Take the building. Now, here what is given? Height of the building is given, that is 6 meter, and height of the tree is given, 8 meter. Then shadow of the tree is given, that is 6 meter. What you have to find out? You have to find the shadow of the building, length of the shadow of the building. So here you know that these two triangles which are there, they are similar. These type of questions are discussed in the earlier videos. So you take which triangles are similar here. You have to find out BP. So triangle ABP is similar to triangle CDP. Here what you have to find out? You have to find out BP. So you write BP. BP by DP equals AB by CD. BP CD is given, that is 6 meter, and AB is given, that is 60, and CD is 8. Then BP equals 60/80 × 6. 60/80 × 6. So you can take 2 4s are 2 3s are, then 4 1s are 4, 15 3s are 45. You got the answer here. What is the answer? 35. So here what is the answer? Option D is the answer. 45 you got. Here you must use the concept of the similar triangle. Tree and building are parallel to each other. They are perpendicular to the ground. So directly here you can get that their two triangles are similar. Next question you take. What is the question? Question number 36. Volume of a tanker formed by using a sphere and a cylinder of volumes 100 cm cube and 200 cm cube respectively. This tank is the combination of cylinder and hemisphere. The volume of a tanker formed by using sphere and a cylinder of volumes 100 cm cube. Here, if you combine these two, you will get a sphere. So what is its volume? That is 100 cm cube. And cylinder volume is 200. The total becomes 300 cm cube. Total is 300 cm cube. So what is the answer? It is very simple. If you have the fundamental knowledge, you can identify the answer easily. So that is 300 cm cube is the answer. Option C is the answer. Then you take the question number 37. If the surface area of sphere is 616 cm square, then the diameter is. Here what is given? Surface area of the sphere is given. What is the formula to find the surface area of the sphere? That is 4 pi r square. 4 pi r square is equal to what? 616. Then you take 5 value, 4 into 22 by 7 into r square equals 616, then r square, or also you can write 4 r square, you write 4 r square equals 616 into 7 by 22, then 616 into 7 by 22, then you can take 11 2s are 11 5s are 55, again here 6 is remaining, 11 6s are, then 2 1s are 2 28s are, so you will get 4 r square equals 28 into 7, 4 1s are 4 7s also you can write, then r square equals what, 7 into 7 r equals 7 you will get, and diameter is 2r, that equals 14, that is also you got that diameter is 14 centimeter. What is the answer here? Option D is the answer. Option C is the answer, 14 centimeter. So you got the answer option C. 7 2s are 14 you got, that is option C is the answer. Then you take the relation between the slant height L, height H and the radius R1 and R2 of frustum of a cone is, the relation between slant height L, H and R1 and R2. Now the question number 38, the relation between the slant height L, height H and the radius R1 and R2 of frustum of a cone is. Children, you must know this formula. The relation among the radii of the frustum of cone, slant height and height, the relation is L square equals H square plus R1 minus R2 whole square, or R2 minus R1 whole square. So here option B is there. Note down the answer, option B, L square equals H square plus R1 minus R2 whole square. Then you take the question number 39. The radius of the cylinder of height 20 cm formed by melting a sphere of radius 15 cm. Here what you have to find out? We have to find the radius of the cylinder. And what is the height of the cylinder? That is 20 cm. And this cylinder is formed by melting a sphere of radius 15 cm. And here you must have the knowledge that the volume of the sphere is equals to the volume of the cylinder. Volume will not change. If one solid is melted to form the other solid, the volume will not change. So what is the formula for the volume of the sphere? That is 4 by 3 pi r cube. You consider this is r1. That is equals to volume of the cylinder. That is equals to pi r square h. You consider this is r2 square. That is 4 by 3 pi pi cancels. Then r1 means, that is the radius of the sphere, 15 cube equals r2, we have to find out, write it as it is, r2 square into h, h is 20. Then you can have 4 1s are 4 5s are, then here that is r2 square equals 15 cube by 3 into 5 will get. Here if there is any doubt, you write this as 5 into 5 into 5 by 3 equals r2 square into 5, not 5 it is 15 into 15 into 15, 15 into 15 into 15, so 3 1s are 3 5s are, 5 5 cancels, then r2 square is equals to 15 into 15, then r2 is equals to what, you will get 15 only, r2 is equals to 15. So what is the answer here? Option D is the answer. What is the answer? Option D. Note down the answer. Option D. Then you take the next question. The ratio of heights of frustum of cones having same base 1 is to 2. Then the ratio of their volumes. Here what is asked? Ratio of the volumes. The ratio of the heights of frustum of cones are given. That is 1 is to 2. 1 is to 2, here you can have the formula 1 by 3 pi h1 into r1 square plus r2 square plus r1 into r2. Here also 1 by 3 pi h2 into r1 square plus r2 square plus r1 and r2. Here the ratios of the volumes we have to find out, and the radius are same here, radii are same. So here you will get h1 by h2 only. H1 by h2 is given, that is 1 by 2. You got the ratio h1 by h2, which is equals to 1 by 2. So that is 1 is to 2. The ratio is 1 is to 2. So what is the answer? Option A is the answer. Option A is the answer. That is 1 is to 2. Children, there are 5 question papers. This is the completion of the first question paper. Let me solve the next question paper.